How to send email from your own domain without getting blocked. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question. I have a domain, call it randomisp.com. I want to send email from my domain. By that I mean I want my email to be from me at randomisp.com. For the life of me, I can't get this to work. I don't need to receive. That's handled elsewhere. Just send. This can be a really confusing situation just to describe. I mean, we're all perhaps using Gmail to manage our email and we're sending to and from and with our Gmail email address. But what if we end up buying our own domain? As I have, right? Multiple domains. What if we want to send email from our email address, in my case, say leo at askleo.com, without having to like bring in a whole bunch of other infrastructure to make that happen? Well, as it turns out, it's certainly possible, but honestly, the more of the appropriate infrastructure you can bring to bear on the problem, the more likely it is your email will not only be sent, but actually be delivered. Approach number one, which I will call the least reliable, but also the easiest, is to lie. Now, it's important to realize that for many email systems, your email address and your account ID are two different things. They might have the same value. They often do. It's typically the email address, but they don't have to. So when you configure an account using some other provider, you can just lie. In the example here, I've specified that my email address is me@randomisp.com and that my outgoing mail server, which is what's used to send the mail, is that of Yahoo. If this were to work, I would send email from my email address using Yahoo's mail servers. This is very unlikely to work. Yahoo's mail servers should not allow email to be sent from domains that Yahoo does not control, even if you are signed in using a Yahoo account. Even if it worked, recipient email services are very likely to consider the messages as spam because the domain in the email address, randomisp.com, doesn't match the domains owned by the sending service, yahoo.com and others. This is honestly a huge red flag for spam filters. It's one of the reasons I refer to this as lying, because in effect, you're saying Yahoo is okay with this, when in fact, Yahoo is very much not okay with this. This can be horribly abused by spammers and can then turn around and negatively impact Yahoo's own ability to send legitimate email. And to be clear, I'm using Yahoo as my example because it's simple, obvious, but it's actually true for any other email service you might try to do this with. Now, the second approach is what I will refer to as sending only. This requires that your domain, in this example, randomisp.com, has email support of some sort. And yeah, that's something you'll need to check on because when you register a domain, it may not come with email support. Very specifically, it must support your ability to use SMTP, which is the protocol that's used to send email. You could then configure your email program to send using that service. For example, here I'm using Gmail's ability to send email from another address. In a previous screen, I specified me@randomisp.com as the from address, and now I'm configuring the SMTP server to be used when I send email using that address. You'll note that the username is unrelated to me@randomisp.com. It's just some other account at randomisp.com. This is why I say your email address and your account or your username may be two different things. It's okay if this turns out to work with me@randomisp.com if you have a password for it, but in some cases, I've been known to set up accounts specifically for this purpose that are just used to send email from a variety of other email addresses. Exactly how you connect to your specific SMTP server, that'll vary depending on the SMTP server itself. Its name, its port, 587, 465, occasionally even 25. Whether it's a secured connection, which kind of security, those are pieces of information you'll need to get from whoever is providing the SMTP service for your domain. Now, when I send email from me at randomisp.com, here's what happens. Step one, Google's email service connects to mail.randomisp.com and signs in as sending account at randomisp.com. Using that connection, Google's mail server then sends the email I'm sending to mail.randomisp.com. Then step three, randomisp.com's email server can then send the email on to its final destination. This ensures that email from randomisp.com really came from randomisp.com, from that server. That password requirement is what makes sure that only allowed individuals can do this, not spammers. Third is probably what you were trying to avoid in the first place, but honestly, it tends to be my recommendation. And that's just set up a full-on account with that specific email address. In other words, configure your email program to both send and receive from that email address as if it were its own standalone email account, because it is. In this example, I've set up the complete account in my email program for me at randomisp.com. The account is configured to both send and receive email directly to and from randomisp.com's mail server. This is the simplest and by far the most common solution. I say it's the simplest because conceptually it's the simplest. You've got an email address, it's a full-on account, it's what 90% of email addresses are in the world. It's not always the simplest to set up because you have to set up a separate account. But even though I've shown you the configuration details here, many email programs will actually make a pretty good guess at filling in that information for you. And they're often really close to being correct with maybe just a little bit of tweaking on your part. It's the most reliable approach because it's the most direct. Your account sends email through your provider. There's no secondary sending account required. You're going through the provider associated with your email address. As I said, this is the approach I recommend. Now, my example uses an email program. Happens to be Thunderbird, in case you were wondering. But you can often configure webmail services, including Gmail, to send and receive email from other accounts in this exact same way. Bottom line, yeah, my recommendation is that if you can, use a full email account to send email from the email address you're trying to send from. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/178975. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.